Good morning, and it's always a good morning when we get to check in with our friends Hunter and Parker at Wind FM. Hey, guys.
Good morning. How are you?
Hello. How's it going?
Feel like we're moving, we're grooving. I'm going to give the half shimmy because it's Thursday, not Friday.
All right, I'll give you a quarter shimmy. I'm still trying to work my way out of Wednesday. So
it's all about fractions now.
Oh, my gosh. Don't get me going on math.
Well, looking forward to this weekend. We have the North Central Florida Indoor-Outdoor Expo.
That's the
new
thing
we're calling it. It's the Outdoor Expo, but we're indoors at World Equestrian Center on Saturday from 9 to 3.
Yeah, it's a fun event. It's free. We've got so many vendors and outdoor-branded activities and presentations. So you can check out the information ahead of time at windfm.com. But we wanted to get out of the heat. We wanted to get out of the rain, possibly. And now we're looking at Fred. Mike, we're just kind of wondering what your personal thoughts are on this system.
Yeah, Fred's kind of complicating things a little bit, but not for the entire weekend, I don't think. I think today and tomorrow are probably going to be pretty typical summer days, but then the moisture from Fred is going to make its way northward. Based on what we're looking at right now, certainly it's going to complicate what's already been a wet period for June, July, and August so far. Dixie County's been under a flood warning here for a number of days now because of the rains we had last week. So I think it means a surge in moisture. And so we'll have an increasing rain chance on Saturday, kind of going back to kind of like what we had at times last week. But I think Sunday and early Monday is going to be when the bulk of our rain comes. I think that's going to be the main thing is the rain and the flooding it causes because we already have damp soil. And then I think there'll still be some wind, you know, to a certain extent. But it really depends on if Fred can recover. It's looking pretty weak this morning.
So it's also probably then a good thing that the Outdoor Expo is inside, and hopefully they maybe have like some rain boots and things you can buy. Get your rain gear for sure.
Yeah, it's inside on Saturday, and Saturday I think would be the better of the 2 days this weekend if it's going to be a better day.
Yeah. So, okay, well, good. We got lucky on that front. So it's always a good time. It's an annual event of ours too, that Outdoor Expo. So come on by. And of course, Mike, we always appreciate your input and keeping us updated on everything that's going on.
Yeah.
Hunter and I were talking earlier, and we wanted to ask you guys this question too. Now that school's back in session, the thing that we were best at in school was eating lunch. What was your lunch? Did you guys pack your own? My mom always packed mine, and she always made sure I had something healthy. I had a ham sandwich mainly. Chips, my dessert, and the carrots, the grapes were always in there too, but they were always left.
You really were healthy.
I never really ate the carrots and grapes. Those were left over a lot, so I'm full at them.
Did you have a lunch box or did you brown bag it?
I always had a brown paper bag and the little, I wasn't too cool.
Yeah, well, what about you guys? Did you have lunch boxes?
Brown paper bags. And not a plastic one, a metal one. It was a metal lunch box.
Wow.
My first one was in the shape of a like a barn, you know, like a red barn. And the next one after that was Charlie Brown, which I remember. But it was like either peanut butter or ham sandwich, maybe a little bag of chips and a little thermos.
Oh, I was spoiled. So I always had like maybe every few years I got a new lunchbox. I'd always had some kind of glitter, something sparkly because. What else do we expect from me? And then it was always, it depended what was on the lunch menu for that week in school. Because if I liked it, then my parents were like, okay, cool, you can eat lunch there. And then if I didn't, then it was packed lunch. And that would just be whether it's Lunchables, a sandwich, or who knows.
Yeah. All right.
Lunchables.
We're back to Lunchables. Yeah. This guy over here still eats Lunchables.
I was so jealous. I would be so jealous of you, Lisa. Oh, she's got Lunchables.
I would always share, though. I always shared my snacks and things. Sharing is caring, people.
Oh, that's so cute.
But it has your essential foods there, right? A little bit of meat, a cracker, and some cheese.
Whatever fake things are in that meat.
Good to go for your day.
Mystery meats.
Yeah, that's great.
I was a peanut butter and jelly girl. I had a Snoopy lunchbox when in first grade, but after that, it was brown bag all the way.
Yeah, you can't go wrong. You can't. Yeah. I wish I still had my mom making my lunch these days. You know, I still got to that point.
Yeah.
And since she,
hi, Mom. We're on TV.
I totally agree with Parker. Yeah.
So, and Parker said can't go wrong. We can never go wrong when we talk to them every week.
Talk with Wind FM.
Yeah.
Great catching up with you guys.
It's always good.
Well, thank you. Good catching up with
always
you too.
Good.
Stay dry.
Have a good rest of your day.
All right. Take care.